Hi everybody, welcome to Genius Channel. So today I'm going to discuss one important concept which is related to the current affairs. Today Hindu has come with an editorial. The news is Pakistan is in gray list. So we need to know the concept behind this. We need to know what is FATF and related concepts. Okay, so let us start this. Yeah. So looking at the history of FATF, it is G7. G7, it was G8, Russia was out of it. Okay, so held in 1989. See, when you are sitting in my class, okay, it's an online class, so I need you to have a notebook and a pen and take down notes as if you're sitting in the real class. Okay, don't watch this as if watching a movie. Okay, otherwise there's no use. Okay, so FATF stands for Financial Action Task Force on Money Laundering. That is what the full form, just not just force. Okay, normally people will say just Financial Action Task Force, but actually it is Financial Action Task Force on Money Laundering, established in 1989 as a part of G7 summit held in Paris. Okay, so these are the important things. So these are G7 came out and say that we have to do something for the terror financing and money laundering. First actually it was money laundering basically. Okay, the Financial Action was established in July 1989 by the group of seven countries, summit in Paris, initiated to examine development. Write down the initial goal of FATF was only to examine and develop measures to combat money laundering only. Okay, in 2001, okay, it expanded its mandate when it got expanded to combat terror financing. So only in 2001, this is coming in. Okay, till then it was only money laundering. Okay, in addition to the money laundering, in April 2000, it added efforts to counter financing of proliferation of mass destruction. Okay, so this can be a chronological question in our exam possible. 2000, originally 1989, what was the mandate? Then what was the mandate added in the 2001, and what is the mandate added in 2012? Okay, 2012, they said counter the financing of proliferation of mass destruction. Okay, so it has been doing a lot of good work. It was bringing a lot of pressure on the countries. Okay, so now it is known as, right on, global money laundering and terrorist financing watchdog. Okay, for example, you might have heard about IAEA. It is a nuclear watchdog of the world. Likewise, terror financing and money laundering global watchdog is FATF. Okay, FATF works to generate political will to bring about national legislation, national laws you have to bring, and to regulate reforms in these areas. Okay, so this exact word is important. Please note down this. Okay, yeah, if I'm going fast, please pause the video and write down, then you proceed. If you're spending 10 minutes, there should be a meaning for it. It's not just I spent FATF and a question is coming, I don't know. Okay, so all the other all countries of the world, almost 200 countries, okay, are committed for implementing the recommendations of the FATF, right? Okay, with more than 200 countries and jurisdictions committed to implement the recommendations. Okay, so that is known as the FATF recommendations. Okay, what is their work? They work to stop funding for weapons of mass destruction, already I told you. Okay, so this you can read. Okay, so these are the main things. Okay, some of the recommendations is in which they talk about financing techniques, countermeasures, promote adaption implementation of FATF recommendations globally. So the objective of FATF, right, to set standards and promote effective implementation of legal, regulatory and operational measures for combating money laundering, terror financing and other related threats to the integrity of the international financial system. Please copy down from here to here to understand what is the objective of FATF. I repeat that, objective of FATF, that means what is the aim of FATF? To set up standards and to promote effective implementation of legal, regulatory and operational measures for combating money laundering, okay, terrorist financing and other related threat to integrity of the international financial system. Okay. Yeah, now coming to the members, there are 39 members. This can be a question, so please remember all 39 countries. So Canada is there, Mexico, USA is there, Mexico is there, Brazil is there, Argentina is there, okay, South Africa, Australia. Okay, so if you read with the map, India is there. Okay, in fact, Pakistan is also there. Okay, I think so. Okay, China is there. Okay, so all these countries are there, but here Pakistan is not. I have taken from Wikipedia, let me see. Okay. Pakistan is not there. Okay. But still, Pakistan is put under the gray list. Okay. So it did Portugal, these are the countries. Please remember this. Argentina, Australia. I told you, in addition to 39 countries, there are 200 countries which are ready to implement the recommendations. Okay. 39 countries, actually not 39 countries, 37 countries plus two regional organizations. One is the European Union, the other one is the GCC. Okay. So, and one more observer is also there. Remember this observer as if now is Indonesia. Indonesia is the observer. Status is given to it. Okay. Now, very important FATF is their recommendations, what they recommend, what is the action they want the people to do. Okay. So that keep on changing. Okay. So right on total recommendations so far they have done is 40 plus 9 recommendations. Okay. 40 plus 9. No need to remember all the recommendations. If possible, read this 39 members. That may be a question. That may be a question. The aim, what is the aim of this one? When it was created, who are the members behind this G7 summit? Those things are possible. Okay. So that you have to read. Okay. Now, why this is there in the news? Okay. Why this is there in the news? Pakistan needs recent news. Pakistan needs legislation to meet the 3 outstanding FATF benchmarks. Okay, that 3, if you want, you can read today. That is there in today's newspaper. It is an editorial. So what I have done is I have added the editorial in our Telegram group. You can download it. Otherwise, you can see in today's newspaper, Hindu newspaper, it is there. Okay, I think the heading is Cold Comfort, something like that. Okay. Pakistan will have to make further legislation to at least count. So Pakistan gray list, they are not going to blacklist. Okay. There are 2 countries which are already in the blacklist. One is Iran, another one is North Korea. Okay. If it is in blacklist, then it is very difficult to do any export or import those things. Okay. Yeah, let me know, guys, if you understood this, any doubts there, you can always call me. This is my number and you can also WhatsApp me. I'll be happy to help you guys and wish you all the best. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.